lesson on Thursday. I'll just make it quite simple. And it's really just to do with the structure in your backswing. So the first lesson being, you know, getting you into a position where you can, you know, effectively return the golf club to the ball in a more consistent position by changing the position that you're in at the top, or where your backswing kind of moves into your downswing. So transition, it's called in the golf swing. So if we take a look at your first swing, which is one on the left-hand side. So setup is good. Then we move in position two, okay, and this is still okay. And then this is where it starts to kind of break down now. So the arms tend to start to bend, the club starts to get a little bit too steep here. And the club obviously gets very long and into a position here where the structure of the arms really is the problem here. So the left arm's very bent, the right arm's very bent as well. And then from here, because the head is so far kind of in front of the hand, so it's not, it's an issue that is long, but the issue is that because the club is so far what you call across the line at the top, to try and get yourself in a position where the head is actually going back behind the hand, so this dot almost goes back behind this dot, is really, really difficult. So what you do is you shift your hands out and forward in an effort to try and get the head behind the hands, which you do. Okay, so now you've got a position where the head is behind the hands, but the hands are just, or the arms are just so far out in front of you. The only real way you're going to get the ball, the club back onto the ball now is kind of pulling the hands upwards, lifting the hands up, and you'll get a really high shaft. Okay, you can see it's just a struggle. I think this one was just a shank, and a bit of a nothing shot, really. So if we move, and this was the last swing that you did, and you can see it's darker, and you've actually got a wood on this picture. But for the sake of showing you the differences, it doesn't really matter. So, sorry, let's move this one. So takeaway is still good. You know, you weren't too bad up until here anyway. So what we've got you is a little bit more depth in the arms. Okay. If I put the one on the left in the same position and the lead arm's parallel to the ground, okay. You can see we've got the glove hand is much more inward, if you like, and we've got rid of, through a little bit of rotation of the forearms, you can see the shaft is starting to, we'll just use the term less steep, if it makes sense. We put the correct kind of rotation into that right arm, and you can see now. So this effectively here is kind of the top of your backswing here, and this is your top of the backswing here. Okay, so you can see the structure of the right arm's totally different. Left arm's much straighter, a lot more depth in the arms. Okay, you can actually see now how you start to get the club to shallow much earlier. Again, I'm not going to blind you with science in how we did it, because I don't think it's going to help you in terms of your practice. But you can see, totally different. And then that right arm is a feeling of coming in towards the body. Body rotates and still move a little bit too far out in front of you, just a touch. But again, if you go lead arm parallel to the ground on the way down versus lead arm parallel to the ground on the way down here, which is there, it's just two totally different. From here, you can play golf. From the one on the left, you're going to struggle big time. Okay? So, the object of this is for you to be able, when you film your own swing, is making sure that you're in this position where you've got some degree of, oops, angle in the shaft. Okay. We want this a little bit more shallow, really, or a little bit more pointing outside the ball. Again, just keeping it simple. Okay, but you can see for yourself that the two frames, which are the same when the left arm parallels,